Would you like to know how to answer the tricky tech interview questions? If so, this video is for you. In this video, we will discuss the key tech interview questions. We will specifically cover the tricky tech interview questions, those tech interview gotchas that can kill your tech interview either before you start the interview or during the interview. Now, most of the questions we'll cover today will actually be tech interview behavioral questions. Some of them will be more related to your class and your finesse. When it comes to building a great tech career, your tech interview mastery is essential. If you didn't know, most tech jobs have a $50,000 to $100,000 pay range between the top and bottom paid person on the team for the same job. And how well you get paid is dependent upon how much you impress the hiring manager on your interview. And we want you to know how to sell yourself and position yourself for maximum success. So please keep watching this video and wait until the end for some free things that we have to help you in your technology career. The tech interview questions that we will cover today include, what are your salary expectations? Tell me about a time that you failed. Tell me about your strengths and your weaknesses, and have you ever disagreed with your manager? The first tech interview question we will cover today are, what are your salary expectations? This is a tricky tech interview question, and in 90%+ of cases, you should not answer this question. If you answer this question, you're going to have two problems. One is you may not get the interview as you price yourself out of the market. Or, even worse, you get pigeonholed to a lower salary before you've had a chance to actually interview for the position. So don't make this pre-interview mistake. Let's be fair. You would not buy a house, a car, or anything without truly understanding the product. And you can't tell someone your salary expectations until you truly understand the job. And you won't know about the job until you speak to the hiring manager. You're not going to get anything from a job description. Effectively, they're almost worthless, but the interview will tell you exactly what the job is. You'll have a chance to interview the company, interview the hiring manager, and find out if it's right for you. I want you to really remember that in the interview, it's equally important for you to interview the employer as it is for them to interview you. So I don't want you to answer this question. I want you to treat the interview as a sales call, because it really is. You are selling your services to the employer, and you want to sell your services for the maximum dollar, pound, or whatever the local currency is in your part of the world. So take a lesson from the best sales professionals. Excellent sales reps do not provide pricing until the customer is excited by their product. That's how they sell for maximum price. And you should do the same for you. We want you to get the maximum salary, and there is a huge pay range for most tech jobs, generally speaking between $50,000 and $100,000 between the top and bottom paid person in the position. So wow the employer, and then you'll be at the top end of this range. And in many cases, if you wow them, you can even get a better job than the one you applied for. I've only worked for 5 companies. On my first tech interview, it was for a network engineer position, and I had no experience, no background whatsoever, but I wowed them so much on the position, they actually hired me for a network engineer 4. Now, I applied to be a network engineer 1, and there was a network engineer 2, 3, and 4, and I was hired as a network engineer 4 with zero experience. Of course, I did spend 2 weeks preparing for that interview, and so should you. On another interview, I applied to be an enterprise architect. Instead, I was offered a distinguished architect position with a much higher pay, and it was a much bigger position. So don't sell yourself short. Wow them on the interview and then negotiate your salary. Don't provide an answer to this question, but you do need to respond to the question on what are your salary expectations. And there are many approaches to giving the perfect answer here, and we cover them all in our Tech Interview Mastery program. But for the sake of this video, I want to give you one option to think about. A simple response could be, I'm more concerned with finding the perfect fit than just salary. I want to be in a place where I know I can deliver maximum benefit to the employer and be in a place where I can build a long-term successful career. And after the interview, we will both know each other so much better, and I will be able to give you a much more definitive answer. So the point is, you need to punt that until the interview is actually over, when you know them and they know you, and you've had a chance to wow them and show them how wonderful you are. The next question is to tell me about a time that you failed. Now, this is another tech interview gotcha question, and it can either kick you out of the room and end it or get you hired. See, the thing is, let's face it, everybody fails at some point in their career. And if you haven't failed, it means you haven't tried. And no employer ever wants someone that doesn't try or hasn't tried, because it's going to show that you won't try for them. What matters is not that you failed, it's how that you failed. During the time that you failed, did you leverage all the resources at your disposal? Did you communicate effectively? Did you manage the expectations of all key stakeholders? During the failure, did you damage the relationship with others, or did you build deeper relationships, or were you at least able to salvage those relationships? Was the customer upset, if applicable? And if so, how did you make the customer happy? How did you remedy the solution? Now, since you made a mistake, what have you done to make sure that you've not made the same mistake again? And what are you doing to avoid future mistakes? What did you learn in the process of making a mistake that makes you better prepared for the future? These are what the employer is truly asking about. So make sure you address these in your response. The next interview question is, tell me about your strengths and weaknesses, or tell me about your weaknesses. Right now, I'm just going to cover the weaknesses. We all have weaknesses. And how you answer the what are your weaknesses is a critical tech interview question. So you must have one, because we all have weaknesses. What the employer is trying to see is if they can live with you and your weaknesses. But they also want to know if you know yourself. And this is very critical. So why does the employer want to know if you know yourself? Well, I'll read you a passage from The Art of War, which tells you everything you need to know. If you know the enemy and know yourself, you need not fear the result of 100 battles. If you know yourself but not your enemy, for every victory gained, you will also suffer a defeat. And if you know neither yourself nor your enemy, you will succumb in every battle. So let's face it, business is war. And the employer wants to know that you will be a good soldier fighting for them on their team. So you must know yourself. Now, to be fair, you must be able to tell them about a real weakness. And you must sound authentic, which only comes out of honesty. So let's evaluate weaknesses. If you have a knowledge gap, no big deal. An employer can simply send you for training. But there are showstopper weaknesses, and these weaknesses will immediately disqualify you from the job. So if you have any of these, don't mention these. And truthfully, if you have any of these weaknesses, we strongly recommend that you get help to overcome these weaknesses, as you'll have a much better life and career. Some of the critical showstopper weaknesses are laziness, or the inability to get along with others, or a violent temper, or the unwillingness to be a team player. So give a realistic example of a true weakness, a weakness that will not scare away the employer. For example, one of my weaknesses is my organization skills. So I might say something like, my weakness is my organizational skills. By nature, I'm not the most organized person in the world. So to mitigate these weaknesses, I keep a set of checklists to make sure that I stay organized. The next tricky tech interview question is, have you ever disagreed with your manager? When you analyze the question, you really want to know what they're actually assessing. And what they're assessing is your problem-solving skills, your communication skills, your emotional intelligence. So you need to answer this question in a manner that's going to highlight your emotional intelligence, your problem-solving skills, your leadership skills and communication skills, because that's what they're really trying to gauge. Now, when you answer this question, I need you to be positive in your response and be respectful of your manager, even if they were wrong, because the manager wants to know that you can take direction and be respectful from the manager, because they too may be wrong sometimes. And in your response, I need you to stick with professional issues. Now, ideally, pick a conflict that had a positive outcome. Keep your story simple and keep the listeners engaged, and please keep reading their body language along the way so you know when to keep talking and when to stop talking based upon the interview's body language. As you can tell, these questions are far deeper than what the employer is just asking you on this tech interview question, because they're trying to find out who you are and if you're a good fit for their organization. If you truly want to maximize your interview success, we have a tech interview mastery program that will give you a complete unfair advantage to win the interview over everyone else that's out there. And you can see a link for this program in the description below. Now, we also have many free resources to help you in your tech career, and we put them in the description of our YouTube videos. Please download, for example, the free How to Get Hired Every Time ebook. It's an ebook to help you win the interview, and the link is in the description below. If you desire to become a cloud architect, please get the free ebook and join us on How to Become the Ultimate Cloud Architect webinar. Again, the link for this is in the description below. Additionally, we have so many free guides to help you with your tech careers, and it's in the description of so many of our videos. And I look forward to seeing you in another video very soon. Take care.